The doctor's in. Michael Perotti joining you from Final Round Atlanta 2018. I am being joined by the man, Sajam. How's it going?
Pretty good. Are you a PhD or am I? I don't know which of us is the doctor.
It's supposed to be me, okay. But don't ask for my transcripts. All right, so we're here in Atlanta. We've seen a lot of Street Fighter. We've seen a lot of Dragon Ball. Those are probably the two biggest ones people are looking at. But who have you had your eye on more?
I had a lot of... I don't know. I was really focused on the Dragon Ball exhibition. I was really excited to see it, especially because this is the first clash of international competition that Dragon Ball has seen. But in general, Final Round is always like the launching point for all games, right? It's the start of the Tekken World Tour. It's the start of the Capcom Pro Tour. It's the first international competition you see all year for most games, and that includes Dragon Ball, which is a super new title. So I don't know. I was excited for everything, basically.
So you mentioned the exhibition. So there's a rumor going around that there was a Street Fighter caster plot, I guess I could call it, to keep James Chen on the desk during the exhibition. What do you have to say for yourself?
Before the schedule was created, I sent an email that said, what do I have to do to not be on at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, or EDT now because of during the exhibition. And they said, all right, I was the first one. They're like, you requested to be off, you're not on. And then like three other people sent the email and James was, he was last. That's all that happens. He made a mistake. It's not my fault. He sent the email late.
So there's no nefarious undertones there.
I just asked to not be on. That's all. I said, look, I'd like to be in the crowd for this one. I'll put in the shifts at other times. Just take me off.
All right. So you've been on the mic almost all day today. You know, I showed up at like, I think 10:30 and you've been there since then. So it's not a short day.
No, today's my long day. Yesterday was a little shorter. I think I did like 4 hours of commentary or something. And today I have six, I think, which isn't too bad. It's like a 12-hour day, so we're rotating like five of us. But yeah, I had the morning shift from 10 a.m. to 2, and then I have the start of top 64 with Yipes at 6. So today's a little bit of a longer day, but I have a lot of commentary stamina built up.
So this year, there's actually been a lot of commentators who are working long shifts. I don't know how much you pay attention to other esports. We have Papa Smithy in the LCK, who's the only color commentator, so he's working 6 days a week. We have desk hosts in the CS majors working 13, 14-hour days because there's only one of them. You know, you said your long day today is 6 hours. Do you feel that maybe we need more people?
Yeah, probably. I mean, those hours are absurd, right? I've certainly done longer days than today. And I know lots of people who have. Like, it's not uncommon to put in a 12 or 14 hour day. So I've done that, and not so long ago. So I understand what it's like. But thankfully, for like CPT events now, there's usually a spread of enough commentators that even over a day that's, you know, 10 to 10 like we have today, there's five of us rotating in. So you do about 4 to 6 hours each. But yeah, I've had tournaments where there's three of us on a 16-hour broadcast, and you end up doing 10-hour. Like at Evo, I did a 10-hour or an 8-hour shift in the morning from like 8 a.m. to like, I don't know, 4 p.m. or whatever it was and something like that. It just happens. Like sometimes some people drop out and you have to step up and do the extra work. But yeah, it would be nice to have like a spread in those situations, especially like what you mentioned. That's just absurd. Like, yeah, they need to hire some new people. And it's not like Riot doesn't have money, so I don't know what's going on there.
That's very true. And, you know, we've seen some of the higher profile commentators mention that they're not hitting as many events this year. You know, we've seen Ultra David say he's cutting down. We've seen Sadokist in the past say he's cutting down. Is there anything like that in your future?
I thought about it, actually. That was a thought on my mind. And then I did Evo Japan, and I just wanted to do every event in the world. Like, I immediately felt the lifeblood pumped back into me. So, I don't know. I'm still super young, and I have a lot of energy. So, and like I said, I have long commentary stamina. I can do 10-hour days back to back to back, and it's not unusual for me to commentate 6 or 7 days a week. So, yeah, for me, it's like, I don't know. It's everything I do. So, I don't know. I'm kind of used to it, and I don't plan to cut back. If I do, then I would just be streaming or creating content or doing something else.
Yeah, I mean, you're a very busy man. I'm always seeing you on Twitter saying you're doing analysis vids, you're doing this, you're doing commentating that, you're, you know, all these different, you know, locals and things like that. So is this really what drives you? Is this the lifeblood, is hitting every event and doing all this fun stuff?
I think it's like one of those things where if you want to be as good as you can at something, you have to make it your passion and your life. So to me, it's like, I never want to have the feeling that I didn't try my best and put in the work that's required. And I never want to, like, the worst feeling is for a big event to come up and for you not to get hired because you know that you are not good enough or didn't work hard enough to get there. Like, for me, my goal is to always be as best as I can be. And if I don't get picked, then it's my own fault and I should just work harder to get there. That's sort of my philosophy.
All right. That's very great to hear. And, you know, it is always nice seeing you at these different events. Speaking of the event that we're at now, it's final round, and there's been some actually kind of high-profile names dropping out. We've seen Momochi drop out and things of that nature. So with who's left, who do you got?
Oh, boy. This is a really hard question. My personal favorites are probably – I have, like, a top three for Street Fighter, which is Infiltration, Tokido, or Nemo. Those are the players that I hope to make it super far, especially Nemo. I really want him to do well. He plays – Itabashi in top 64, which is a great match. There's a lot of history there. I'm excited for that one. But like in every other game, I don't even know. I have no idea what to expect in Tekken. There's like tons of really strong Korean talent here and talent from Europe as well. And this is the home of Tekken in the US. So it's going to be really stacked. And Dragon Ball, I think every single top like Japanese player that entered, I expect almost all of them will make top 8. They're super good. And I hope that there is the redemption arc and Sonic Fox comes back and does super well. That would be sick. I'm rooting for Sonic Fox. I'm an NRS player at heart, so I can't lie. But I don't know. I'm excited for everything. And tomorrow, I'm doing nothing. So I'm just going to sit back and relax and watch all the top 8s and enjoy it.
All right. Well, I know you got to head back to your final block today. So thank you for taking the time. And we look forward to talking to you again.